benefit of our listeners, can you give out that number where they can call when they spot a wild animal?
Yeah, well, the number which I am presently giving now is a dedicated number which is there at the headquarter of Aranya Bhavan. That is 080-2334-1993. This is the number which is there in the office of the Chief Wildlife Warden of the state. So, anybody finds this kind of situation in the field can be reported to this number. And the other district headquarter or the taluka headquarter will get back the clear instructions from this number immediately to attend to the situation.
Right. Now the last part, sir. Welcome back, Dr. Raju.
Sir, just say.
Sir, please say. I always insist this number, Raju. How do you keep a check on the health of animals and the birds in the park? Last month, the 15-year-old tigress died due to lung ailment.
Yes, the management of health is a very challenge in the zoo and safari setup. Although we have got four dedicated doctors to work on these animals, still there will be some kind of slips, that I have to admit. But what I have done since last 3-4 months, we have worked out a prophylactic way of managing the animals. So, a kind of a vaccination has been identified for all animals like carnivores and herbivores. They are exposed for the periodical vaccination. So, once the vaccination is done with reference to the special animals like aged or ailing animals or a sick animals or the animals which are carrying or the animals which are lactating mothers. So, all of them are actually exposed for regular test of blood, urine, serum, stools. All these examinations will be done. These examinations will be done to ascertain the function of their vital organs like liver, kidney, heart. All these are actually ascertained. Once it is ascertained, the animal condition is found good, we will not intervene in its management. Suppose if the profile of the blood or if the profile of the urine or a stool is giving some warning, then we will immediately take stock of the situation and try to put the animal into the treatment mode. So, that is how every animal is actually exposed into this kind of scrutiny, health scrutiny, and this health scrutiny is very regular. And once in a month we will definitely do that. In addition to that, every day there is a protocol, definite protocol. Once the doctor comes to the hospital, first thing what they do is that they will take a round and they visit every animal house. They will examine whether the animal is defecated, whether the animal is urinated, whether the animal has eaten all its food given. All these observations are made. If any small difference is actually noticed in the animal house, immediately that will be reported to me. And before me reporting to me, they themselves will take action, what is to be done next and all that. So, that is how the animals are exposed for the day to day health scrutiny and the periodical health scrutiny. And thereby, we have reduced eventualities, because after all, they are the wild animals. We cannot touch them, we cannot feel them, we cannot handle them. We have to guess what is it happening with the animal and all that. So, that is how it is being done. Yes, this tigress which was died last month, she was almost nearing to her last phase of life. Now, tigers normally in captivity, they would live up to 20 years, but in wilderness area, 15 to 16, 17 years, they would die. So, this animal which is died, 16-year-old animal, she was almost crossed her old age-ness. And she was ailing also for long time, she was under treatment, and that is how she has died because of the lung ailment.
One more case, Dr. Raju. A 7-year-old elephant in the park recently gave birth to a premature stillborn baby. The right breeding age for elephants is 14 years and above. Why was this elephant artificially inseminated or?
No, sometime these things happens in human being also. We will be seeing in some population like living in the forest and maybe even in the city people also, 14-15-year-old people also, you know,
get pregnant
because of biological, robust biological reasons. So, likewise, even in the animal kingdom also this robustness is there. Yes, it is a fact. This baby elephant, what you are actually referring, roughly around 9 year old, I believe. So she was actually, got conceived and premature birth was there, and
stillborn.
Stillborn only, stillborn only. And normally, this is not a normal happening in the animal population, but here and there, sometime it happens.
Dr. Raju, entry of wild animals into the park is another threat. A few months ago, a leopard entered the park and killed a female deer. What steps have you taken to prevent this kind of intrusion?
As far as the enclosures are totally closed, the animals are safe. So, the closed enclosure concept is there in the zoo itself. But in the safari concept, the enclosures are not closed. 100 acres, 200 acres of open enclosure area, and the animals are very free there. So, there this kind of killing is happening. Leopards are there in the open forest area, and these animals are housed in the open forest area. And here and there some kind of happenings are always there. And last month also, as you rightly said, one leopard came out from the forest, and of course, the safari also is a forest only. It's a original forest where we have housed all these animals. So it's a naturally balancing activity. Rather, once the animal population is multiplying, there has to be some kind of mortality also, and this is one of the way the animals are actually. And we. Yeah, in addition to the leopard, we also have the problem of elephants. So, the wilderness area has got a lot of elephants, and particularly one elephant which is coming to the zoo area, and somehow he has developed affinity with our zoo elephants. So, he comes right at 4 p.m. in the evening, and normally because that is the time we are letting all our elephants out into the forest, and he would wait at the gate and take all of them along with him, and next day morning he will bring them back and leave. That kind of an affinity is also there, and not much of threat to the animal population, but this kind of a harmony is a good to watch and it's happening.
Sorry. Dr. Raju, I believe you are planning a new entrance to the park. Will it be an addition to the existing entrance, or will it be the new one?
No, it's a totally new entrance park. It is. See, the earlier
one will be closed.
Yes. Earlier entrance, we have already closed it. The earlier entrance, what we had, it was only a transit, entrance park. Entrance to the park. So now what we have done is a very good entrance, and with all kinds of modern facilities we are trying to provide there, electronically well established ticket issuing system, and electronic surveillance will be there, and the total high tech entrance gate it is.
And it is already there now.
It is already there in place, and green energy that we are using, we have put one wind turbine there, and we are getting the power through the wind energy, and that is the new addition. I don't think any park in the nation has got that green energy concept, and we have done it.
Dr. Raju, you have also said that animal viewing experience will be expanded. How do you plan to do that?
Yes, the existing safaris, we are finding for the population what we are having with us to the safari area is a little crowdy population. So therefore, we want to expand, creating additional facilities itself. We are adding up the new area in the forest itself. Say for example, white tiger safari, that is around 10 hectare of area what we have with us, around 25 acres. So we have 10 animals at our disposal. So 10 animals in 25 acres, it's a very small area. So, people also do not feel that they are viewing the tigers in the forest. So, we want to widen the existing area and make it double or triple, and people should search and see the animal, not that animal should be readily available for their sight. So, that is a kind of a provocation to them, that they must feel that they are searching for the animal, and after search the animal should be available, then only they will appreciate the beauty. If the animal is appearing in front of them, they are just casual. So that is
that
the way that
in
we
a
are.
Zoo.
Yes, right. Yes, that can be in a zoo concept.
So work
like
has begun on.
Yes, work planning has already been started, and we are going to expand it. And people who are visiting Nagarwala or Bandipur, they are actually taking round in the safari area, and they are trying to search for the animals. And after 2-3 rounds of search only, they will be able to see some animals. And then they are excited. So that kind of an excitement has to be provided here. So that is the reason.
So we are working on that.
We are working on it.
How long will it take?
It would take 2-3 months of time. Yeah, well within that we are going to do it, and this is a planning year precisely, and probably next year everything has to be put into action, all plans will be put into action, and we will see that the plans are implemented and people are actually given a pride of seeing all these plans.